Hello and welcome to Azure Wala. We are in Microsoft Certified Associate series. Today we are going to discuss case study 1. Congratulations to Amir Mustafa 9665 for passing this exam. Congratulations Simran Bhagnani 8836 for passing this exam. Congratulations Charlie Dur 8035 for passing this exam. And congratulations Leila for passing this exam. Litware Inc. is a consulting company that has a main office in Montreal and two branch offices in Seattle and New York. The Montreal office has 2,000 employees, the Seattle office has 1,000 employees, the New York office has 200 employees. All the resources used by Litware are hosted on-premises. Litware creates a new Azure subscription, the Azure Active Directory, Azure AD or Entra ID. Tenant uses a domain named litware.onmicrosoft.com. The tenant uses the premium P1 pricing tier. Existing environment. The network contains an Active Directory forest named litware.com. All domain controllers are configured as DNS servers and host the litware.com DNS zone. Litware has finance, human resources, sales, research and information technology departments. Each department has an organizational unit that contains all accounts of that respective department. All the user accounts have the department attribute set to their respective department. New users are added frequently. Litware.com contains a user named user1. All the offices connect by using private connections. Litware has data centers in Montreal and Seattle offices. Each office has firewall that can be configured as a VPN device. All infrastructure servers are virtualized. The virtualization environment contains the servers in the following table. We have server 1, which has VMware vCenter server and it contains the virtual machine 1. We have another physical server, server 2, which is having Hyper-V environment and that is running virtual machine 2. Litware uses two web applications named app1 and app2. Each instance on each web application requires 1 GB of memory. The Azure subscription contains the resources in the following table. In Azure, we have VNet1, a virtual network, VM3 and VM4 virtual machines. The network security team implements several network security groups. Requirements or planned changes. Litware plans to implement the following changes. First change is deploy Azure Express route to Montreal office. Migrate the virtual machines hosted on server 1 and server 2 to Azure. Synchronize on-premises Active Directory to Active Directory or Azure AD. Migrate app1 and app2 to two Azure web apps named web app1 and web app2. Technical requirements. Litware must meet the following technical requirements. Ensure that Web App 1 can adjust the number of instances automatically based on the load and can scale up to 5 instances. Ensure that VM3 can establish outbound connections over TCP port 8080 to the application servers in Montreal office. Ensure that routing information is exchanged automatically between Azure and routers in Montreal office. Enable Azure Multi-Factor Authentication for the users in finance department only. Ensure that Web App 2, azurewebsites.net, can be accessed by using the name app2litware.com. Connect the New York office to VNet1 over the internet by using an encrypted connection. Create a workflow to send an email message when the settings of VM4 are modified. Create a custom Azure role named role1 that is based on the reader role. Minimize cost whenever possible. Question 1. You discover that VM3 does not meet the technical requirements. You need to verify whether the issue relates to the network security groups. What should you use? Option A. Diagram in VNet. Diagram in VNet will not help us to verify the issue related to network security group. Therefore, this is not the correct answer. Option B. Diagnostic settings in Azure Monitor. Diagnostic settings in Azure Monitor is created and configured to send Azure platform matrices, resource logs, and activity log to different destinations. Therefore, it is not the correct answer to verify the issue related to network security group. Option C. Diagnose and solve problems in traffic manager profiles. Azure Traffic Manager is a DNS-based traffic load balancer. This service allows you to distribute traffic to your public-facing applications across the global Azure regions. Therefore, Traffic Manager profile cannot help us to verify the issues related to network security groups. Option D. The security recommendations in Azure Advisor. Security recommendations in Azure Advisor help us to manage our cost but doesn't help us to verify any issue related to any resource. Therefore, this is not the correct answer. Option E. IP Flow Verify in Azure Network Watcher. IP Flow Verify is a feature in Azure Network Watcher that you can use to check if a packet is allowed or denied to or from an Azure virtual machine based on the configured security and admin rules. It helps you to troubleshoot virtual machine connectivity issues by checking network security group rules and Azure Virtual Network Manager admin rules. It's a quick and simple tool to diagnose connectivity issues to or from other Azure resources, the internet, and on-premise environment. Therefore, option E is the correct answer to verify if the issue is related to network security group or not. Question 2. You need to meet the connection requirements for the New York office. What should you do? As per our case study, we know that in New York office we do not have any data center and we have only 200 employees. Further, all the offices are connected using the private connections. And on the Azure, we have VNet 1 only having virtual machines. Therefore, if we connect the virtual network with the New York office, it will serve the purpose. As per our technical requirements, we just need to connect the New York office to virtual network 1 over the internet by using encrypted connection. We will need site-to-site VPN connectivity between New York office and virtual network to fulfill this requirement. To create site-to-site VPN connectivity between New York office and virtual network, we will have to create a gateway subnet. Under the gateway subnet, we will have to create a virtual network gateway and a local network gateway that will communicate with this virtual network gateway, and that local network gateway will represent the IP addresses for this VPN device at the New York office. Let's go to answer area. From the Azure portal, create an express route circuit only. Express route lets you extend your on-premise networks into the Microsoft cloud over a private connection, and we are looking for connection over the internet. Therefore, the first option is not the correct answer. Create a virtual network gateway only. Only virtual network gateway can help the point-to-site connectivity. Therefore, it will not help us to create a site-to-site connectivity. Option 3. Create a virtual network gateway and local network gateway, which is the part of our solution. Next two options are incorrect. In the New York office, deploy express route is not required for site-to-site connectivity. Deploy a direct access server is not needed. Implement a web application proxy is not required. Configure a site-to-site VPN connection is needed to establish site-to-site connectivity. Question 3. You need to implement role 1. Which command should you run before you create role 1? To answer, select the appropriate options in the answer area. From the answer area, we can understand the role 1 is cloning of a reader role. To clone any specific role, we need to get the definition of the role in JSON format. Therefore, the get-az role definition will be the correct choice. Then we will pass the name of the role, which is the reader. Then we will convert the reader definition to JSON format. So we can use this JSON format definition and implement a new role, role 1. Therefore, get-az role definition and convert to JSON are the correct answer. Question 4. You need to recommend a solution to automate the configuration for the finance department users. The solution must meet the technical requirements. What should you include in the recommendation? Let's go to technical requirements. The technical requirement for finance department is enable Azure Multi-Factor Authentication for the users in finance department only. To implement the multi-factor authentication for finance department only, we can create a dynamic group and we can associate the dynamic group with the conditional access policies. Therefore, option B, dynamic groups and conditional access policies, is the correct answer. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button. Subscribe to my channel. Press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.